him. But a seed has to be planted. A seed got to have dirt put on top of it. If you take a seed and throw it on the concrete and walk off, the sun just burned it up. But guess what? Logically, in my mind, it doesn't make sense that to grow something, you should dig a hole, put it down in there, and cover it with dirt. Logically, that don't make no sense to me. But oh, though. See, dirt is necessary for growth and development. Dirt builds character. Dirt gives you the push-through factor. Dirt makes you come with it when you don't feel like coming with it no more. And you get dirt in a lot of different ways. All of y'all that had dirt throwed on you. And dirt ain't always what you want. It's somebody talking about you down on your job. It's somebody accusing you of something that you didn't do. It's somebody telling you you ain't gonna make it. It's somebody sharing information about you that ain't true. That everybody get dirt put on them. That dirt builds character in you. When they talking about you, it teaches you to withstand it. Then it gives you something to push through. So when you put the seed and you put the dirt on it, if you understand stress, stress really ain't just dirt. Stress, see, they don't call it dirt when they plant it. They call it soil. Because, see, soil has nutrients in it. What the nutrients, when people talking about you, dogging you, lying on you, backbiting, stealing from you, talking about you, they're actually putting nutrients in you. They're building character. You got character now. Now the seed, if they put a camera under the ground, you'd have seen the seed sprout open and start coming through the dirt. Because the dirt is necessary so you can prove yourself. You know, if you don't really want to be, everything you see above ground that blossoms and plants and grows and that's beautiful, it was underground one time. All them potatoes, collard greens, they was underground one time. Them apple trees, they was underground one time. So they had to prove theyself. See, you want to be successful, well, then you got to prove yourself. You got to push through the dirt. You got to come up through here. You got to come out. Then you sprout, and then bishops say, then you become a tree. Next thing you know, you got fruit. So when you're under stress, take the stress for what it is. Don't get fooled. Don't just think, oh, man, Lord must not mean for it to be. What you tripping for? What you talking about? How you think you're going to be a plant, a tree, a flower, a bush, and ain't no stress? How you going to get to be that without no dirt? We ain't even perfect. See, I expect dirt now. I expect people to talk about me. Matter of fact, I look forward to it now. Do your thing, because if I can weather what happened to me and my family earlier, you can bring whatever you got now. There's some more stuff going around now that's about to happen. Bring it. Because now I have developed a character that is stress. I have soil, enough dirt on me that has provided me with nutrients. So now, let me help you understand how hard it is to be successful. It's very difficult because more people would be successful if it were easy. It's like doing 100 push-ups. You know, the average person can't do 100 push-ups. That, now, some of you in here... you can't do 100 push-ups. I just looked and went, come on, Steve. But because of the fact that it's difficult, you're not going to try. They take rocket ships, take them to the moon, orbit, bring them back, land it in the same place it took off from. You don't want to try the 100 push-ups?
Right.
You don't really think you can do the 100 push-ups? See, thing about push-up is, once you get started, it's difficult. But let's say by the grace of God, somehow, you get 20 cranked out. And then you just keep on, and then you throw some prayer in the game, and next thing you know, you got 40 knocked out. But you steady pressing. What you don't see is you developing a strength with that pressing. And then somehow you get to 70 and you look up and everything on you shaking. Your teeth is cracking. Your eyes is busting out your head. You can't believe what's happening to you. You get to 80, your clothes don't look the same no more. You somehow somehow get to 90, and it's all coming loose now. And then, through prayer, in some kind of way, you ain't got to know how. You just got to start. See, too many people try to figure out the how. Now you're trembling. You're shaking. Everything in you is about to blow up. But you done 100 push-ups. Now, somebody come to you and say, man, you say, well, I did the 100. I'm successful now. And then you say, well, good. Now I'm successful. What I got to do to stay successful? Hold that position. After you done 100, lock and hold. That's how hard it is to be successful. But in that mere description right there, most people go, I ain't finna try that. What got me to this position is I went ahead on and tried it. I didn't even have the ability. And I still have struggled. But guess what? I'm holding. But I ain't holding by myself.